Well, it's not just the ceiling we've brought down. Hopefully today we're going to bring your electricity bill down as we look at dimming LEDs to save energy. So lighting represents one of the biggest electrical loads in residential and commercial buildings. And to go with that, we've chosen to look at downlights when it comes to dimming, because they are one of the most popular light fittings that you see installed. Now, when it comes to dimming, you want to make sure that the performance is there as well. So we've chosen these Robus Ultimum downlights because of the breadth of the range, but also their great dimming performance.
The lights are only one part of the equation, the other being the dimmer. This dimmer here has got a feature that we haven't shown on the channel before, so make sure you stay around for that. So you're all set up to prove to me that dimming LEDs will save me money.
Yeah, and it's an easy question to answer. We've got our four Robus downlights in our Mimic ceiling here that we're right up against. And on that, connected to this Haymeg power meter, you'll see we've got about 21 watts of power. And then if I start to dial that down with the Robus grid dimmer, we'll see that as soon as I start dialing that down, the power falls. You may not have picked it up yourself because you don't tend to notice the loss of light at the high end. It's only when you get into the lower end dimming that you really, the eye starts to see it. And you can see we can smoothly dim to off, but I've set that low end. So you can see with the lights nearly off, we're only using a watt of power. And yeah, we can still see on the bench here.
Yeah.
It's shown there, yeah, 18 lux. Turn it back up just so the audience can see us and throw a question out there. How do you work out how many downlights you need to light a typical space?
I'll answer it. So on social media, I see rows and rows, and even in my own property, that gridiron approach, which floods the area with light.
Yeah, and a lot of people, so people like to get an even illumination, which when it comes to downlights can mean actually overlighting the space. And of course, lighting's very subjective. It's down to your personal preference. I remember growing up, the big light was never switched on. It was always the table lamp.
Yeah, it wasn't a thing in my day, but in your day, it probably was, wasn't it?
Well, in your day, obviously, older people need more light as well. So again, very subjective. And we try and fit a one size fits all, depending on the property, but that gives us potential to save energy. Now, to put that into context, our Metro light meter that we've seen in a recent video as well, connected to the MFT, then you can see it's measuring 1,000 lux. Now, for some reference there, that's what you typically have on a workbench where you're having close up inspection work. It's double the light level that a consulting engineer would design to in a typical office, and can be 10 times the level of a typical living room. So we can dim down easily, and as I say, obviously we dim down, we expect the light level to fall, but also a significant difference in the power level as well. So let's drop down to that 100 lux. Obviously our power has gone down from 21 watts to just under 3 watts of power.
This Ultimum range of LED lights that we've installed here have got your electricians covered. They're easy to install and connect. And across the range, they come in different wattages, the ability to be color selectable, tiltable, IP65 for bathrooms, and all of them are dimmable. So this is a scenario. Okay, the energy bill's dropped through the letterbox. I've opened it up, and for 2 weeks, I've gone around and dimmed down all my LED light fins. A couple of weeks have passed. The kids don't care. The conversations we had, we're back to full brightness.
Yeah, well, they don't care because you're paying that bill. But there's a great feature built into the grid dimmer to help you out there, Gary. So what you can actually do on this is trim the high-end output.
Okay, so I'm used to trimming the low end, aren't we? When we're dimming down to and stopping at a certain point, you're telling me we'll do the same in the upper end?
Yeah, so the little potentiometer in there, you've got the low-end one, you're right, that sets that smooth dimming that we want, and we demoed that earlier on, but you can also reduce the power output down to about 60% of its full power.
So automatically on 40% saving on full brightness?
Yeah.
Oh, right.
And you still get the great dimming performance, but you've just limited the power output. Now, that has two other great effects as well. Obviously, when you're running LEDs at a lower power, you do improve the long-term reliability. You also improve the lumen maintenance over time. So obviously, lumen maintenance runs in tens of thousands of hours. It stretches out there. The lower power they run, obviously, the less light you lose over time as well.
So there's no loser there. I'm saving energy and making my light fittings last a considerably longer time as well.
Yeah, let's also not forget the biggest energy saving comes from moving from halogen, and there's still lots of them around there, to LED. Massive energy saving by doing that.
Of course, the most energy efficient light is one that isn't on. If you're lighting areas like this, however, you want to check out the Robus Golf range with the video over there.